Today, the Johto True Power Tournament will feature the second Elite Four member in the tournament against a gym leader who has, until now, been the lowest ranked by the league itself. Last time we got to see a thrilling battle between two closely ranked gym leaders, Chuck of Cianwood and Morty of Ekrutique, which showed just how much sheer resolve can do to power one through a battle that is very closely contested and fierce as can be. Today we'll have the opportunity to see a match between Gym Leader Falkner of Violet City against current Indigo Plateau Elite Four member Karen. Let's head to the team previews to try and get an idea of how this match could shape up. Falkner enters the tournament with a wickedly powerful and offense-heavy team with sweepers galore from Swellow to Staraptor to Aerodactyl. Interestingly, one of his Pokémon is not actually entered in our database, so we'll have to see what exactly is going on there as the match proceeds. Karen, on the other hand, has a great mono-dark team that's quite balanced with a defensive core in Vileplume and Umbreon, and some powerful sweepers like Weavile, Houndoom, and Gengar. Word from our producers has arrived that our trainers are on the field and ready to battle, so let's head to the arena and see what awaits us. It's time, the second Elite Four member to enter the tournament. We've got Karen of the Indigo Plateau versus Falkner of the Violet Gym. Karen's going to start off the battle with a Weavile. Weavile is a very, very big threat for Falkner's entire team, actually, whereas Falkner's going to send out the Staraptor. Now, Staraptor 2 is also a big threat for Karen's team. We're going to have to see very strong lead choices from both sides. The Staraptor does have the Intimidate ability, of course, so that will lower the attack power of the Weavile, but Weavile's going to stay in here and go with the Icicle Crash, stab super effective Icicle Crash on the Staraptor, but oh, the Intimidate saving the Staraptor there, 26 HP remaining, going for a 4x effective close combat on the Weavile, but the Weavile survives. It looks like it might have, yes, the Focus Sash, saving that Weavile just barely. And now, of course, both trainers might have a priority move. Let's see what happens. No, Falkner's actually going to withdraw. He's going to stand down from the Staraptor and send out the Crobat. Oh man, perhaps predicting maybe an Ice Shard. Yes, the Ice Shard coming out on the Crobat. Crobat is fairly defensive, but that is super effective and is not doing too much after that Intimidate. So Weavile being able to pull off yet another Ice Shard, realizing the Crobat would outspeed. So it does have to go for a relatively weaker move. And now the Crobat's gonna go with the Acrobatic to take down the Weavile. So Falkner eliminating one of the biggest threats to his team early on. Of course, that is at the cost of having two of his Pokemon severely weakened now. And here comes the Umbreon from Karen. Umbreon, of course, one of her signature Pokemon that a lot of trainers know her for. And now the Crobat going for Taunt. That is a great move on Umbreon, but Umbreon actually going on the offense here and going with the Foul Play, but the Crobat survives! Crobat surviving with 18 HP just barely and going for the Roost now. That is a good play from Falkner, because if that is Umbreon's only attacking move, that is going to be dangerous. The Crobat will be able to recover more. Yes, it looks like it might be more than it is actually taking in damage. So Crobat surviving really well. Karen's going to be forced to back down and withdraw from this Crobat, and now sending out the Honchkrow. Honchkrow, a good counter actually for Crobat, because of course Crobat can't do too much offensively, one would imagine. And here comes another Roost for the Crobat, bringing it back up to huge health. We'll have to see what this Honchkrow has in store. Crobat, of course, outspeeding though, going for the Acrobatics. Looks like it might not have an item at all, and doing over half health on the Honchkrow. That is crucial. But the Honchkrow able to respond now with the Night Slash, critical hit. Now that Honchkrow does have an interesting setup with Super Luck and the Scope Lens, of course, with Night Slash having a high critical hit ratio, but here comes the Sucker Punch. Wow, Falkner perhaps not predicting that the Honchkrow would have both Night Slash and Sucker Punch. A good moveset there from Karen, being able to out-prioritize and take down that Crobat. But now the Aerodactyl coming out. Aerodactyl will also be faster than Honchkrow, that is for sure. But now Karen's going to actually withdraw here and go back out into the Umbreon. Umbreon, a great physical wall. Aerodactyl going for the Stealth Rock though. Oh, an amazing play there by Falkner. Of course, if the Honchkrow had gone for Sucker Punch, the Stealth Rock would have canceled it out, or Karen would be forced to switch. So either way, it was a free Stealth Rock. A great play there from Falkner, and now going for the Rock Slide on the Umbreon, perhaps hoping for not so much damage, but flinches here. That would be key, and the Umbreon going for the Toxic actually. Karen perhaps maybe predicting a switch, or just wanting to put this Aerodactyl on the timer. Of course, Aerodactyl is not the bulkiest Pokemon out there. And now Umbreon getting a little leftovers recovery, whereas the Aerodactyl is going to start racking up damage from this poison. We're going to have to see what Falkner wants to do here. He's not in a great situation now, but going for the Rock Slide on the Umbreon again. Can he get the flinch though? It does not look like it. The Foul Play now coming out from the Umbreon should do a good amount of a huge amount of damage from that Umbreon. Actually, Aerodactyl might go down to the Toxic on this turn. Umbreon showing some offensive capabilities too. The Aerodactyl actually going down now. So Umbreon, a big, big threat here for Falkner's team. I don't know how he's going to deal with this. The Staraptor now coming out. Of course, the Intimidate, in case Umbreon does have any other physical attacks, will be a good option. But Staraptor, of course, does have close combat. But no, it's going to go with the Brave Bird. The Stab Brave Bird on the Umbreon, perhaps predicting maybe the Gengar switch on Karen's behalf, because that is not going to take down the Umbreon, and the Staraptor going down. So maybe Karen even perhaps... Oh, yes, she went for the Wish. Oh my word, she perhaps predicted that Falkner would actually predict that she'd go for the Gengar to take care of something like the close combat, of course, which would have been super effective on the Umbreon, but Karen did not switch into the Gengar, instead going for the Wish instead. Oh my word, and now Falkner sending out Swellow. Swellow is a hugely, hugely powerful sweeper, especially when it gets its Guts ability activated. So we'll have to see. Yes, Swellow going for Facade here, but the Umbreon using Protect, so it's got a Protect and Wish combination. Look at that. How much recovery is getting. Unbelievable. In addition to the leftovers, too. This thing is a big, big nuisance. Swellow now having its Flame Orb activate. So, yes, it is a Guts variant with Facade, which will double power and is Stab. So that should do a huge amount of damage, but not enough. Umbreon is an absolute wall right now, going for the Wish again. And now all of a sudden, this Swellow is kind of stuck out on the field. Now, the problem is Falkner doesn't really want to switch in against an Umbreon because, of course, it has either Foul Play or Toxic. And those are two very, very unfortunate moves for any Pokemon that switches in. So now the Umbreon going for the Protect again. And Swellow just trying to get some damage off with the Facade. It has to be careful, though, because it is getting burn damage every turn. And the Umbreon now looks like, even after the leftovers, it might actually get full health. Back up to full health is this Umbreon. Now, we're starting to see a little bit of a weakness here for Falkner's team in that he doesn't really seem to have a status move to deal with this Umbreon. Now going for the U-turn, though, getting some pivoting capabilities. That is a good move there. Making sure to get a super effective pivoting move on the run. And here comes the Lugia, the legendary Pokemon. Of course, we have seen Falkner with this in the Pokemon World Tournament years ago, back during the events of Black 2 and White 2 in the Unova region. And now it is showing its strength here. It's on the field, going for the Calm Mind now. So Falkner realizes if he's to take out this Umbreon, he needs to charge Lugia up big time. So special attack and special defense will be raised on the Lugia. And now here comes Umbreon with the Toxic, though. That is a bad, bad situation for Lugia. Lugia is very bulky, but of course it is now on a timer with that Toxic, and Umbreon yet again at full health. We're gonna have to see what Falkner has planned. This is really the only way he has to deal with Umbreon, with some special attacks. Obviously, this Umbreon is very, very physically bulky. It does have a good base special defense too, but it might not be EV trained in special defense. So now another Calm Mind coming out from Falkner, and the Umbreon going for the Foul Play. Now, this is another problem, is that Umbreon is actually super effective against Lugia too. In addition to the Toxic capabilities, Lugia getting a little recovery here from the leftovers, but of course that Toxic is going to start wearing it down really, really fast. Falkner's going to need to go for a move soon, but oh, can he do it though? The Protect now being used by Karen on the Umbreon, so now all of a sudden the Lugia will not be able to attack, but it is going to go for Calm Mind again. Oh my word. Falkner being absolutely relentless with charging this Lugia up. It is going to be a powerful beast, but again, it does not have much time to work here. Going to have to see what Falkner has up his sleeve, because this Toxic is going to probably bring it down below half now. Yes, well below half on the health on the Lugia here. This is dangerous. Lugia now going for Recover though. Oh, that is a bit of a game changer. The Recover actually should bring it up to, almost full health. Umbreon going for Wish again though here. So this is a dangerous situation still. Even with the Recover on Falkner's behalf, he has to be a little bit careful here. Almost full health after that leftovers, but now the poison's gonna really start racking up. Yes, doing some good damage on that Lugia. Lugia definitely has to make a move soon, and the Umbreon going for Protect yet again, making sure to Toxic stall this Lugia. But the Lugia going for Calm Mind. Are you kidding me right now? Falkner, what are you doing? Another Calm Mind on the Lugia. Perhaps he's hoping for a one-shot kill on this Umbreon. I mean, he does need it, to be fair. But of course, if he does have something like Aeroblast, it does have a high critical hit ratio. Perhaps that's what he's hoping for here. Perhaps that is what he needs. And that poison doing big damage. It is time. Here it comes. The Lugia with the Aeroblast on the Umbreon. Will it crit? No, it does not look like it. Umbreon actually surviving too after all those Calm Minds. Here comes the foul play. Lugia is at low HP. The leftovers will come into effect, but I don't think that's enough. The Toxic will inevitably take that Lugia down, and Umbreon just above red health there at the end. Here comes the Toxic, and yes, the legendary Lugia has been downed by an Umbreon of all things. And now Falkner does have an opportunity, though. He did weaken that Umbreon severely. He has the opportunity to outspeed and take that Umbreon down now, but the Umbreon will go for Protect, getting a little bit more burn damage on the Swellow, of course, and a little bit more leftovers recovery, not that it will likely do anything against a Facade from a Swellow, of course. Here comes the leftovers recovery now. Will this Umbreon go down, or will Karen switch? Karen doesn't have anything to really switch in. She could go Gengar, but then again, it would just get outsped on the next turn. So yes, she's gonna keep that Umbreon in there. And the Swellow finally able to take that thing down. We have seen trainer after trainer struggle with that Umbreon in particular in the Indigo Plateau. So it's kind of no surprise that even Falkner is having difficulty with it. Now the Honchkrow coming out, getting hurt by that Stealth Rock, of course, and Swellow's gonna actually switch out, doesn't want to take something like the Sucker Punch perhaps, and going into his own Honchkrow here is Falkner. So now the Sucker Punch, yeah, so the switch was a good choice there. Of course, the Sucker Punch, Karen wanted to go for that just in case she could try and take down that Swellow. But now the, whoa, that was not a crit there, it looks like, on the Sucker Punch from the Honchkrow. Interesting, but now the Night Slash taking down Karen's Honchkrow. So, wow, we got a Honchkrow versus Honchkrow battle going on here. Not something we might have expected to see. But of course, Honchkrow is going to get a little bit of Life Orb damage here, so it doesn't have the Scope Lens. But now the Houndoom, Karen's other signature Pokemon, is on the field here. Houndoom is a big beast, and of course, it does have the Houndoomite being activated on the field. We've got Mega Houndoom on the battlefield officially. This is a big, big threat for Falkner's team as well. It is going to outspeed the Honchkrow and go with the Flamethrower here. Flamethrower will take down the Honchkrow, even from above half health. So man oh man, maybe Falkner trying to survive and go for something like the Superpower. That would have been a great move, but now he does have the Swellow. His Swellow is his last Pokemon, whereas Karen has three left, but she is going to switch out here. This Swellow could very well sweep the rest of her team. It is possible, but now the Gengar coming out. Did she perhaps predict? Yes, she predicted the Facade. So the Facade will not be able to take the Gengar down. Of course, it does not affect it, and a little bit of burn damage here on the Swellow. Karen has to be very careful, though, and switching out again is Karen. Going into the Vile... Oh! She's forcing the Swellow into Brave Bird to get some big, big recoil damage, especially against Vileplume, which has higher HP. Man, that would be a genius play if this works out. We'll have to see. The Brave Bird, though, will inevitably take down the Vileplume. Vileplume going down. Karen is down to her Houndoom, her Mega Houndoom, and her Gengar. Swellow taking a lot of recoil damage and some burn damage, too. So it all depends. Here comes the Gengar. She's forcing the Swellow to use Brave Bird yet again. But will it be enough recoil? That Houndoom will go down instantly to a Facade if it is switched out. Here it comes. The Brave Bird on the Gengar. It will take this Gengar down. Inevitably, it just depends if the recoil damage is enough. Let's find out. Yes, it looks like it is a genius play there from Karen. Could you imagine? Oh my word, sending out the Gengar, baiting the Swellow into the Brave Bird, and switching out into the Vileplume to get some super huge recoil damage there. What a play. That is the intellect of an Elite Four member. Falkner putting up a very, very good fight, but Karen just absolutely managing a lot of his Pokemon besides the Swellow. The Swellow did amazingly well, but of course that Lugia, even the legendary Lugia, not able to do enough. That Umbreon is quite a monster indeed. Karen will be moving on to the next round with a 1-0 victory over Falkner. Make sure to smash that like button and subscribe with notifications on so you don't miss the next matches. Before we go, I'd like to thank the patrons who are making this tournament possible. If you guys want to help further this series' potential and support it, the link to my Patreon page will be in the description below. That's all for this one. This has been SilphSpectre, and I'll see you guys next time for more True Power.